Breakups are often the symptom of problems in a relationship. My workbook series, The Knowledge, is focused on helping you change your life in four key areas: retaining the information that I teach, personal growth, improving your relationships, and of course, reattracting your ex. Available now at AskCraig.net. Hi there, I'm Coach Craig Kenneth.
Hi there, I'm Coach Margaret.
And today we're going to be talking about one major thing that you can expect from your ex.
And what might that be?
Well, the major thing that you have to prepare yourself when you're going through a breakup is that they are not going to be the version that you are used to. They're going to do a lot of things that are very out of character from the way they used to treat you or interact with you.
Okay, and that's very disturbing to people who've been broken up with.
Yes. I remember the first time I really felt it was with the Applebee's girl, where I could not understand how this person, who I had been so close with and loved me so much, could just completely shut off. I'm talking, I felt like it was a faucet,
like
her love was
a faucet,
and not another drip came out. And that's what was unbelievable, was not another drip, right? I think
You're
maybe,
not alone. Many other people have felt that way.
I think maybe 3 days after our breakup, she called me to check on me, and that was it. I was still so upset and just vomiting my feelings all over her and trying to talk to her and overwhelming her. That was it after that. She didn't want to talk to me after that because I was just too much.
Yeah.
And so it really hurts, because when your ex just acts like a completely different person, it's so confusing, and you just can't understand who they are, if they ever loved you, and why they're doing this.
And the first thought that comes into people's minds appears to be, did he or she ever love me?
Yeah, and we're going to get to that.
If they did, how could they do this?
Yeah, we're going to get to that.
Okay.
First of all, we know that you're going to be shocked, right? Shocked by the breakup, shocked that they're even doing this, because you've been thinking, well, I thought things were going okay.
I thought things were good, yeah.
And chances are you were more focused on yourself and how you were experiencing the relationship than them, and were maybe disconnected from them, where you didn't understand what they were going through, or you were just not paying close attention to the problems in the relationship or when they were expressing their needs to you. That happens too. So you're going to be completely shocked and overwhelmed, and then you're just going to get this intense physical pain where your whole body is just in tremendous amounts of pain and you just can't take it. You're just scared, confused, upset. You start begging instantly, trying to plead, trying to convince, and that just isn't going to work, right? So then you're likely to do some stalking. Driving past their house, driving past their work, stalking their social media, looking for... You become like a detective. You become like Sherlock Holmes.
What are they doing? They would be with me on Friday night. What are they doing this week?
And so... You're going to maybe see that some of their behavior is very different, right? And that's one of the things that can be really confusing, is like, now they're doing things that they would have never done while you were together. They went to club dancing, or they went skiing, or they did all of these things that are out of character. And so we're like even more scared, because now we're so disconnected from them. We're like, who is this new person?
Right.
Not only did I lose this person that I love, they've transformed into this new person.
Other person, yeah, who's not as nice.
And so they're going to be very different. And I think this is very common, especially for people coming out of like a divorce.
Oh, sure. Absolutely. Yeah.
I see that a lot, where people that are coming out of a long-term relationship will kind of regress.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And so, if maybe you've been with them for 10 years, they might start acting like a 20-year-old again, say they're in their 30s, right? Because now, all of a sudden, they're like, all these things that they felt like they couldn't do in the relationship, they want to start to do, right? Now, one of the things that they'll do around you is they will be very cold, very angry, right? Very distant. Why do you think they do that, Margaret?
Well, I think for one thing, if for whatever reason you make a decision to break up with someone you've been with for a while, that number one, nobody wants to do it and nobody enjoys doing it.
Yeah.
So people have to work up to it.
Mm-hmm.
And in order to do what you feel you need to do, you have to pull back. And you can't let your feelings for this person kind of come through because you're going to say goodbye to them, try and tell them to get out of your life.
Mm-hmm.
So I think you disconnect. The technical term is decathect. Cathect means attach.
Mm-hmm.
You start to decathect probably a little bit before you actually do
That's
the
right.
breakup.
And so they so know they were going to do this before you do. And so they're not in shock.
No.
Right?
They're not in shock. And in order to do what they feel they need to do, they have to pull back.
Yes.
But it's really hard for the person who's broken up with.
Yes.
Because they, you know, suddenly what they counted on for sure is gone.
Yeah. Yeah. So they're going to be cold towards you because at the time when they've made their decision, it's not like they think they're going to take you back. It's not like they're thinking, I'm going to change my mind about this. They're like, I'm going to stick to this. This is what I need. This is what I want. And when you're sitting there begging, pleading, trying to convince at that time, they don't care because that's not, they're like stuck in their position. It's only after they have some time to think about things and your behavior changes that they start to wait, you know, wonder, did I make the right decision?
Did I make the right decision? Did I do the right thing? But at first they're shocked and they're as upset as you are because they, even though they initiated it for whatever reason, they feel the loss too.
Yeah. So you can expect them to be cold.
Yep.
And you can expect them to just act like they don't want to laugh with you, they don't want to bond with you, they don't want to try and connect with you, because they don't want to give you the wrong idea.
Right.
Right?
Nor do they want to go through it again.
Yeah, exactly. So they don't want to make you feel like there's hope when at that time they're not feeling like there's any hope. Now this is a key part, because we, Margaret and I have talked about this, we know that you feel like it means they don't love you.
Right. Or they never did.
They know.
That's what I hear so often. How could we be so close if he ever really loved me and then he just dumps me like this, being really cold? He's cold for a reason. He just had to sort of pull back from you. And it doesn't mean he never loved you or she never loved you.
No, of course not. Think about a time in your life where you may have broken up with somebody. Did it mean you didn't love that person anymore? No, of course not.
Probably not.
You probably really cared about them and did love them as a person and wished them the best, but you just felt like the relationship couldn't work for whatever reason.
It wasn't
going
to go anywhere, right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it doesn't mean they didn't love you, right? I mean,
but it feels like that at the time. But I think that's the most common comment I get from both men and women.
Mm-hmm.
Did she ever love me? Did he ever love me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Margaret and I both truly believe that even if your ex is acting cold or distant or mean, they don't call you back, they don't want to talk to you, it doesn't mean that they don't love you.
No,
they just don't want to give you any mixed messages because they are set in their decision at that time, right? Because people make a decision based on how they're feeling in that moment.
That's right.
But those feelings do change. It doesn't mean they're going to want you back. But feelings do change, and how they feel when they break up with you could be completely different 2 months later, 2 weeks later, 6 months later. It just depends on the situation. There's so many variables, right?
Right.
So expect them to be cold towards you. Expect them to be distant or, you know, harsh with you or angry at you. Right? Because if they're angry at you, they're trying to separate.
That's right. That's right. And that's why they have done that. And that's why they turn off their feelings, seemingly, like that faucet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So maybe you could talk about why they put up their defenses.
Well, none of us likes a loss. And, you know, and if you break up with somebody, you're bringing on a terrible loss for both of you.
Yeah.
So we protect ourselves by kind of turning off our feelings when we have to, you know. And that's a very basic defense. But you don't have any warning that that's coming. So the guy who was Mr. Loving last week, is this isn't working out by this week.
And
that's hard.
Yeah. And I'm glad you brought up that point, because I can tell you in my situation with the Applebee's girl, she told me she loved me the week of. I looked at the text messages. Yeah. So it wasn't that she didn't love me. I'm sure she still cares about me.
I mean,
it's been years later.
Yeah.
But, you know, they do this because they don't have a choice, they feel. Like, if they start being nice to you all of a sudden and taking all of your calls and responding to you, what are you going to do? You're going to sit there and have hope that you're going to manipulate them and change your mind. Because let's face it, that's what you're trying to do. Is you're trying to manipulate them and control them and change their mind to get what you want. And that's not fair. That's not respecting them or their decision. It could be really, really hard to learn this.
Right, yeah.
I mean, it took me a long time to understand. Yeah.
But the breaker-upper has to pull back and has to get cold.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so, you know, they're going to look like a new person to you. Now, here's the other major thing that you can see or your situation, not everybody sees this, but if your ex gets into a new relationship right away, and many times they will, they will start to post pictures of them looking happy with this new person, doing all these things that you would have never thought they were doing.
And then it's worse.
Mm-hmm.
Now, of course, see, I told you, they never loved me. How could they hook up with somebody else so fast? Because their anxiety is unbearable, that's how.
Mm-hmm. And so they look excited about their new relationship.
Yeah.
And they are excited about their new relationship because they think it's going to work out.
Which it often does not.
No, because it's based on lust. They're probably lusting over this new person. They're getting all these chemicals, oxytocin, dopamine, serotonin, all these things that makes them feel great around this new person. But very rarely does it truly lead to a long-lasting attachment.
That's right.
Which is, in most cases, what you guys have had, right? If you've been with somebody over a period of a year, that's a solid amount of time.
Oh, yes, it is. Right.
To attach to somebody, right?
Yes.
Unfortunately, some of you guys are with somebody for only a couple of months, and they may not have attached to you. That's just the reality of it. And if you're hurting over that, it's probably because you have had major attachment trauma in your life.
Yes.
And you want to explore that, right?
And always remember that one trauma brings back all the others. One loss brings back all the others. And it's like picking up a string of paper clips, you know, when they stick to each other.
Yeah.
Every time we have a loss, it brings up other losses. The only good news about that is that it means we revisit the other losses as well and probably grow a little bit every time we have to do it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's tough.
It is tough.
Yeah.
And when you see your ex acting like another person or treating you like another person, it's awful because you feel like it's going to last like this forever. And sometimes they do treat you like this forever, especially if you have tried to repeatedly push and force what you're wanting, your desires, onto them. They have to stay forceful with you because you're not relenting, you're not backing off, right?
Right, and then they have to get cold.
Yeah. And they feel like they have to do it.
Yeah.
Okay, so we just wanted to talk about this today because we both think it's important for you to understand that you can expect your ex to act like a different person. Now, that doesn't mean it's going to stay that way. And in many cases, your ex's feelings will change. And hopefully that will reassure you, but your behavior is going to directly impact that.
And what if you do the no contact,
mm-hmm.
right? That gives the person who broke up with you a time to feel what it's like to going to be without you.
That's right.
Yeah.
And then they'll start to get separation anxiety over you.
And wonder if they made the right decision.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But they're not going to do that if you're, you know, relentlessly
still in contact, right?
Pushing and trying to force them to do something that they don't want to do.
Yeah.
Okay. So hopefully this will be a real eye-opener for you guys, especially for those of you that are brand new to the breakup, right? If you've been going through your breakup for a few months, you're like, yeah, I already know my ex is like
but
this.
But if it's just recent, that's the first thing I hear. How could they have ever loved me?
Yeah. Okay. So when you want to get our help personally, just go to my website, askcraig.net, sign up for the coaching option that works best for you. I do email coaching, I do Skype coaching. If you got to get with me right away, I do offer emergency Skype coaching. Margaret is also available for Skype coaching.
Yes, and please keep signing up. I love it.
Just click on Margaret on the top of my website to do that. Make sure you put a like on the video and you subscribe to the channel. That's it for this video. I'm Coach Craig Kenneth.
I'm Coach Margaret.
And we will talk with you soon. I'm Craig Kenneth, a relationship coach and a psychotherapist. Every relationship is different, and every breakup is different. Work with me, and you'll get professional help on your situation. Just click on the link in the description below, or go to my website, askcraig.net.